Are you bored and looking for something to do? Dr. Bug here, and today we're going on a bug hunt with two awesome homemade traps. Let's get building, testing, and discovering what tiny creatures live around you. Let's talk traps. Traps let the insects come to you. It's kind of fun to place your trap, walk away, come back later, and see what you've caught. Before we start, I want you to be sure to only set traps that you will visit each day and then release the critters you find. And when you're done with trapping, put everything away and remove all the signs of the trap so the insects can go about their buggy business. Our first trap is going to be the pitfall trap. Just what is a pitfall trap? It will catch insects that run along the ground. For the pitfall trap, we need a plastic cup or a container like a yogurt container, a small trowel, or even a spoon can work, a tray or something to dump our findings out, and a paper, a camera, and pen. All right, step one is to find a good spot. Level ground is best. Look for sort of a protected area. I'm heading out to a shady area at the edge of my yard. This looks like a great spot for my pitfall trap. Okay, we're going to dig a small hole, just a little bit bigger than your container. This is your pit. We'll place the container into the hole with the rim of the cup level with the soil. Pat the soil you dug out of the pit around your cup to keep it steady. Add a little soil. That makes it feel like a natural hiding space. And now we wait. Check it in a couple hours or the next morning. Bring your tray and let's see what we got. An ant. Take a picture. Take notes. Don't know what you have? You'll need to do some research. These traps help you discover the bugs crawling around when you're not looking. Let's check one more time. A snail. I will record this, then fill the hole, and next up, the bug buffet trap. Our next trap is the bug buffet trap. You will need a plastic water bottle, a ruler, a marker pen, scissors, and tape, like scotch tape or masking tape, really anything you have around your house. You're also going to need a fruit scrap, like a little piece of banana or orange or their peels. Take your marker and make a line evenly, just about one third down from the top. Make a couple marks so you know where to cut. Now take your scissors and carefully cut off this top third. You might need to ask an adult for help to get started. Add your fruit peels or little pieces of fruit like oranges or bananas and just a tiny bit of water. Flip the top upside down into the bottom like a funnel. Insects will find it easy to enter and are not able to get out. Tape the edges closed and set it outside where bugs can sniff out the sweet smell. We want to set our trap outside somewhere sheltered, like next to a tree, taped to a post, hanging low from a branch. I'm going to actually set it next to my vegetable garden. And now we're going to wait and see who shows up to our bug buffet. One thing to be careful with our sweet fruit, if you catch bees or wasps, ask an adult to help you release them. Science is right under your nose, maybe even under that rock. Grab your trap, your camera, and your curiosity. Take pics, ask questions, dig in and see what tiny creatures call your backyard home. Stay curious, explorers. Dr. Bug signing off. Catch you on the next bug hunt.
Ask Dr. Bug originates from the Kids Ask Dr. Bug column, written by Dr. Tamra Reall, horticultural specialist with the University of Missouri Extension. Her column can be found in garden publications, newsletters, and Extension websites. Do you have a question for Dr. Bug? Send them to reallt@missouri.edu. Put Ask Dr. Bug in the subject and include your name and age. or ask your questions online at the address listed here.